Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is chinezeslife. I hope that you guys are all staying safe and, you know, just doing those things that are kind of like keeping you sane during this time. Because again, like literally with so much uncertainty, it's definitely understandable to kind of like be all over the place. But I just hope that, you know, you're finding some type of grounding with whatever that may be. One of the ways that I'm able to kind of just like release, I guess, during this season is just like using my like creative outlet. And I thought of an idea this week. I've been seeing so many like quarantine and chill Instagram lives going on. And I've also been seeing a lot of like TikTok challenges where they use this song. I'm gonna insert the clip of the video that I did.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like I go crunch, grab and bite. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, quite wrong. Fizzy pop, where you they go, where they go up.
So they kind of use that song and it's like this whole thing of basically like getting real cute, getting dressed up, you know, FaceTiming your friends, calling somebody, or just being in the house chilling, being cute. Which is kind of the route that I'm going for today. However, obviously these outfits can be worn when we're actually allowed back outside. Whether that's brunch or date night or just time with a friend. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys the outfits that I came up with.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. I can go crunch, grab and bite. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, quite wrong. Fizzy pop, where you they go, we they go up. Catch my vibe.
This is definitely a spicy dress. So if you're actually going on a date night in the future, I don't know about this for like date night number one. This is definitely for something where you're, you know, more established. Or this is really definitely probably better for the club than a date. I don't know how you guys feel about showing skin, because, you know, it looks like a regular dress in the front, but then y'all see the back? Y'all see the back, right? I think the back was actually the reason that I bought this dress. I bought it back probably in like September. I was gonna be in New York for the weekend and there was this all black party I was supposed to go to and I needed a dress to pop out with, only for the party to not really even go down how it was supposed to. I believe it was from Femme Lux, I wanna say. I'll see if they still have it, and if they do, then I'll link it. But yeah, I just love black in general. And then in the shoes, normally, ooh, I literally have oil and lotion on, so like that's why I'm slipping and I'm on carpet. The heels have like a gold buckle, so that's why I have this bag with a gold buckle on it as well. Just like the little details like that. No jewelry for right now, mainly because I don't really have too much, but I am gonna actually start wearing more jewelry. But yeah, this is definitely just a simple black club quarantine approved outfit. So, you know, if you need a little black dress, I always literally love wearing black like all the time, not only because it's slimming, but also just because it like looks so good on kind of like everyone's skin color. And again, like this dress, this back is like literally like the dress, like it makes the dress. So I'm gonna go ahead and change into the next outfit.
Yeah, jiggy jiggy, heavy heavy, all the girls love me, oh, like money, call me jiggy jiggy, heavy heavy, all eyes on me, Machiavelli, girl, you got me spinning, yeah, yeah, doing too funny.
Okay guys, so this outfit is definitely more calm than the other ones. I would say this is more for like a lunchtime date, I'd say, definitely for the spring. Or for the fall, honestly, if you just throw a coat over it. But this is definitely good for like March, April, going on like a little cute lunch date. Or even brunch, if your brunch isn't like an overdressed brunch, it's just like a dressy, semi-dressed up brunch. So that's where the heels come in. And these are Steve Madden clear heels, but they're not like clear. They're like kind of match the shirt perfectly, which is why I paired them together. As you can see, I couldn't decide on just one clear heel. So the shoes are new-ish. I got them for my trip to Ghana in December. So I got those shoes in December, maybe November, I want to say. The jeans are from Topshop, and I actually got them in Nordstrom for like literally $40. And these are the Joanie jeans, and they're usually literally like $70. And as you can see, they're like super high-waisted and like hide everything, which is why I love them so much. And the fact that I'm even able to fit into them with just semi-sucking, not like full-on sucking, is a good sign. And then this shirt, guys, I've literally been wearing this shirt the wrong way. Like, I used to wear it up on my shoulders, and it's from Forever 21. I think I got it, I wanna say, definitely in like September or October, but I've literally haven't worn it out yet just cause like I never thought that it looked good. Now that I like figured out that it's an off shoulder top, I think it looks like semi good. So it's still like a medium good. I definitely think this should be worn with like pasties though, especially if you are a little bit more top heavy, just to kind of like, I don't know. I feel like this isn't as flattering as I envisioned it, but I think it's still cute. And this little bag, it's thrifted, but I feel like it ties it all together. You have captured my heart, oh, baby, oh. Hey. Anytime I move you, they hold me down, baby, oh. Yeah. But I'm off to shoot my shot, oh, baby, oh. Yeah. My country go away, pray making over the bar. Okay, but guys, can we talk about this jumpsuit though? I feel like this jumpsuit is giving me like I'm going on a date to art gallery vibes, or like I'm going to a wedding, or I'm even going to brunch, honestly. Who says you can't wear black to brunch, honestly? Like, this could be like, I don't even know, like a gala, fancy gala outfit, a banquet outfit. Again, I think this is definitely perfect for a wedding. I actually did wear this for a wedding, and specifically when I was buying it, I just kind of needed something that would be appropriate for such an occasion as a wedding, just in case I was gonna go to one. And I feel like what I love best about it is usually I don't like strapless things, but I'm learning to become more comfortable with them once I've found like what actually works for my body type especially. So I love that this has like that accentuated feature that gives you more like cleavage. And then like it's like kind of like a V, so it's not just plain across. Because I find when things are like just like across just like that, it kind of like takes away. It's like you have no chest. But now it's literally like accentuated. Then I love like the stripes. And guys, literally, this has pockets like on both sides. Like, where they do that at? This is from Express. I believe it was on sale for like $40. Usually Express jumpers are usually around like that $40 to $80 range, but I feel like they always go down to 40, so you might as well just wait until they get to $40. Unless of course you actually like need it. But it's definitely great quality. I would definitely recommend this to people. The only thing is that since I either gained a little weight, I think, in my thighs. So it does kind of like ride up a little bit, so that is kind of annoying to like have to keep on pulling it down. But other than that, it's fine. And as you guys can see, I almost got it closed. My little brother had to help me, but yeah, I almost got it closed on my own, but it wasn't working today. But just know it's definitely possible. I know you guys have been in those times where you think something's not gonna fit, and then a little bit of elbow grease and you get it going. But yeah, guys, this is a great kind of like any type of date, not any type of date, but more so like a fancy date. Again, like art gallery, or if you're gonna be a wedding guest, different things like that. And for the shoes, I got my trusty black Steve Madden heels on. I've literally had these for like 4 years now, I want to say, and they're literally so reliable, one of my go-to black shoes. But yeah, as you can see, it's mainly covered, and although it does have like three straps kind of, only one strap shows, so it looks like it's just a thong sandal, which is great with this, because with an outfit like this, since the jumpsuit kind of like makes the outfit, you don't really need shoes that are like too flashy, so you just kind of want something that's muted, that blends in. So I think those shoes do a perfect job at that. And normally I think it would be best to wear like just like a nice necklace or nice earrings, one or the other, with an outfit like this. But again, guys, I need to get more jewelry, so we're gonna work on that this year, I promise. And as for like a clutch or something, I didn't have one in mind based on the ones that I have now, but I would definitely just do a clutch. I don't want anything on the shoulders since this is an off, no shoulder type of outfit. But yeah, guys, what do you guys think about this outfit? I literally love wearing black, as you guys can see, but I think that this is so flattering. I think jumpsuits look great on everybody, especially if you're shorter or if you're tall. Either way, you're able to add heels to it, just to give like more volume, more depth. And I love how this is like a wide leg too, because you can already see like the poses are about to be immaculate, just serving looks.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
All right, guys, so this is the last outfit that I have. And a little bit of a backstory on these pants. I believe I intended to wear these either for my graduation from college or for my graduation photos, but it never actually happened for me wearing these, at least for my graduation photos, pants-wise. But basically, I ended up wearing it just like as a normal outfit to my line sister's graduation. Everyone thought I was like so dressed up. I was like, really? But anyways, yeah, so these are from 2 years ago and they still fit. But clearly, they could fit better because what's crazy is I remember wearing this. So basically around this time 2 years ago, like these used to have room on it, like it was not this snug before, but it's just nice to see that even though I haven't worn them in a while, they still do fit, even with, you know, I just got to do a lot bit of sucking. And I did take off the shoes that I was wearing just because I was literally like slipping and sliding in them, but they were those same clear perspex heels from before. So this type of outfit is definitely like brunch approved. Like this is like spring brunch written all over it, fall brunch written all over it. So this is a nice white flowy top. I believe it's from Nasty Gal. And what's crazy is I had wanted to wear this shirt in Ghana, but it either didn't come in time. Like I think I had left and it was delivered, or I just didn't have a use for it. And I would have been super hot in this anyway. Like the material is really good, but not for Africa. Like I literally would have been sweating bullets. But I think this is one of those like tie how it looks best on you tops, because I have worn it in a different way, at least in the house. But now I tied it where it's like able to cover my sides. So I think I like that too. Or you could tie it in like a bow in the middle, which I liked, but I think I like this way better. I don't know. It's like feels more secure. In my opinion, the only thing is the back looks kind of ugly, but I'm sure I would be able to manipulate that some way somehow, or if I had someone around to help me tie it, I think it would look, you know, better. So yeah, guys, this is the last outfit. This is definitely like, again, like brunch outfit. This could be for a date, maybe a brunch date, but I feel like this is too dressed up for like a regular date. So that brings us to the end of today's video. Thank you guys so much for staying tuned until this point. Let me know down in the comment section what your favorite part of this video was, or what your favorite outfit was. Again, this is just to show you guys that, you know, you can play dress up in the house. It's okay. You literally put all your outfits together now so that you're more planned when we finally can go outside, guys. You're more planned out. You already know what fits go together. And then of course, it's always just nice to like know like if your body has changed in any way, shape, or form, like based on how clothes fit. Again, like I literally was surprised that these white pants fit after all these years, but here we are, so squeezing in and pushing through. But thank you guys so much for watching and tuning in with me today. We literally are on the road to 1,000 subscribers, and we're so close. So if you're not subscribed, make sure to pause this video and hit that subscribe button. And also, guys, one more thing. Make sure that you're following me on Instagram at chinezeslife. And also on Twitter. I literally tweet like so much, like every single day. But yeah, make sure that you're following me on Instagram and on Twitter, just so you can get more updates in between my videos. I am trying to get back to like a regular posting schedule, not necessarily like a certain day, but more so like certain times. I want to post at least 8 times a month. So for the month of April, I'm definitely going to keep on trying to hit that goal and to exceed that goal. So make sure to leave down video ideas or any suggestions as to what you'd like to hear me talk about or like do, just especially things that are around the house, obviously, since we can't really be leaving the house for anything, especially at this time. So yeah, guys, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.